Okay, everyone, we're back talking about Linux audio and configuring your home studio to use Linux. So I wanted to talk just a little bit about operating system because we kind of left off on that note. You can definitely use, you know, Microsoft Windows. You can use OS X if you want. But my personal preference and what's going to be most affordable for you most likely is using Linux. And there are a number of different ways you can go, literally about a million different possibilities here. So here's an easy way to get to where you want to be. This is just what I do personally. You can actually install a Linux distribution that is optimized for audio production. This is my recommendation. It's KX Studio. You can go to kxstudio.linuxaudio.org and you will find more information about it. You have all of the different plugins that are available. You can read up about them here. Software, applications, plugins. You can read up on what all is included in the repositories. Or you can just go ahead and hop on over to the downloads page. And it's kind of nice. You can download what's called a live DVD, either 32 or 64-bit. You should know what architecture your computer supports, whether that, you know, be 32-bit or 64. Mine personally is 64. And this is it's a distribution of Ubuntu 14.04.2 LTS, which is long-term support, meaning that it is going to be supported by the Ubuntu community for, you know, a number of years. And that's why it's used. It's going to be a little more stable. It does use the KDE 4 desktop environment. So you can see that actually here on my end. That's what I'm using. So this is my recommendation. I would say download this. Here is a disk image. You can download that from any computer that you're using. Mount that to a DVD. So if you have a DVD-R, actually mount that ISO image to a DVD-R. And then you can just throw that in your disk drive. Make sure that your boot options allow you to boot from your optical drive first. If for some reason you don't have an optical drive, as a lot of newer computers don't, you can run this ISO from a USB stick, but you'll need to read up a little bit more on how to do that. I'm not going to get into the specifics there. So what does this live DVD mean? It means you're going to be able to actually use the operating system, try it out a little bit before you actually install it. And I would recommend, you know, before doing any of this, if you do have a computer that has, you know, if you say you're not entirely sure that you want to switch over, you want to try it out for a period of time, you can actually dual boot. And the way to do this would be to go into either Windows or go into your Mac OS and partition your hard drive with whatever free space that you have. I would say allocate about 80 gigabytes or so. And then you could go in and actually install on that partition the Linux distribution that you want to use. Again, KX Studio, this is my recommendation. It's definitely not the only one you can use. There are more popular distributions out there. There are just a number of different things that you can do. This one kind of comes loaded with a lot of the software that I use. And it's really easy to use because it is built on Ubuntu. So once you have that installed, you're going to see desktop configuration pretty similar to what I have. I've made some changes here, obviously. So you're not going to see everything that you see here on my desktop. But one thing you will see for sure is this application launcher menu. I use the very basic menu. You can click on this here. It has your most recent applications that you've used. You can see that I've been working with some images and some modeling. But in the multimedia menu, there is going to be a number of different options available to you here. We have audio production. You can see these all come loaded with KX Studio. You have Ardor, which is what I use primarily. Audacity, which you may be familiar with if you've used it on Windows or on a Mac. Also Hydrogen, that's a drum machine, and a number of different things. LMMS, if you're like me and previously you used ImageLine FL Studio, LMMS is very similar to FL Studio. And let me just show you real quick what that looks like. And that opened on another monitor. So it kind of looks like almost an older version of FL Studio, but you have the same basic setup here. You've got, you know, you've got a pattern, you've got a playlist, you've got your mixer. It's all very similar. If you're used to using FL Studio, you might choose to use this. I, on the other hand, do a lot more tracking and recording than sequencing, so it makes more sense for me to use Ardor. So let's talk a little bit about Ardor and some of the different things that I use along with Ardor. So to start Ardor, you go to the menu here, you can go into multimedia, and you'll notice it's listed under audio production. Another thing that you'll notice if you did install KX Studio is that you'll have what's called a Claudia launcher. And this is pretty neat because it has everything kind of sorted out. You can open this Claudia launcher and it'll give you all of your applications sorted by what they are. So all of your DAW or digital audio workstations are gonna be sorted under this tab here. You can see them all. Different hosts you can see here. You know, if it's your jack rack, your CAF jack host, Carla, whatever it may be, these are all going to be listed here. Different instruments. So if it's like, you know, Cue Sampler, that's what you use for, you know, Linux sampler files. That's what I use anyway for sound fonts. And then Bristol, these are actually different things that are included with the KX Studio. So these are specifically their plugins. And it's a few different instruments, a lot of different synths that are made to emulate, you know, older synths that are actual physical keyboards. So you can take a look at these, you can try them out. They're pretty cool. We also do have different plugins here, and there's a ton of plugins here, and they're sorted by category as well. You know, if you're looking for an equalizer, you can find that. Looking for a synth, you can find that. But just a ton of stuff that's included here. So I really don't think you'll be at any loss to find what you're looking for. These plugins are going to be in what's called LV2 or either LV2 or what's the other one called? LADSPA, I believe, which is the older, basically the older version. LV2 stands for LADSPA version 2. So that's what these are going to be in. If you may be used to using, say, VSTs, some of the digital audio workstations in Linux do support Linux native VSTs. And you can see here what these all support. So if you go into Ardor, you see that it supports everything but DSSI. You can see that this one supports VST native. And you can just kind of go through and see. So LMMS, it's going to support all of your Windows VSTs that maybe you're using in FL Studio. So that's another reason you may want to use that if you're coming over from that environment. But you have a lot of different options here for different DAWs. And yeah, my personal preference is to use Ardor, and we'll get into that here in a moment. So beyond plugins, there's also effects. These are standalone effects that you can use, and you can basically define what your inputs and outputs are for these. And that's kind of the way that the Jack Audio server works within Linux. And it's really powerful. It allows you to basically pipe a ton of different applications together. And, you know, your audio signal chain is also going to be shown on your desktop, and I'll kind of get into that, and that kind of gets into tools as well. So we have different tools here. Audacity, audio editor, you're probably familiar with. There are a few different here. Cadence is actually a Jack toolbox, so instead of using vanilla Jack, you'd be using this. We have a few different things here. And then we have actually a few patch bays. Patch bays are how you're going to, you know, make those connections. And I have one open. Let me just grab it here real quick. So this is my patch bay, and this, I'm actually using this to record the video. So we have our system capture as my microphone one input. I have it sent into the left and right to a CAF compressor. So that's one of the LV2 effects. And then I have that actually going into this Jack input client that is being used by my desktop recording software. So when seeing this, you can see there's a lot of power in using Linux Audio, because anything that you're using here, any programs that use the Jack audio server, they're going to show up here, and you can basically pipe those into each other. So very, very cool how you can do that. Okay, so from DAW here, I'm going to go ahead and click on Ardor 4. And if you have previous sessions, those are going to be shown here. I'm going to click New for a new session. You can decide where you want to create the folder. I'm just going to go with the default Ardor, and I'm going to give a session name of New Jam. And we'll click Open. And let's get started in the next video.